simple. Our human eyes can see the depths of your majesty. You're the God of forever and ever, amen. The Alpha Omega, beginning and end. We sing hallelujah, we worship in old, immortal, invisible God.
Swear, surely shall one say in the Lord, have I righteousness and strength. Even to him shall men come, and all that are incensed against him shall be ashamed. Isaiah 45 verse 23 and 24.
One present at the judgment. I have sworn by myself.
Okay. Historical persons present at the judgment. I have sworn by myself that unto me every knee shall bow, every tongue shall swear, surely shall one say, in the Lord have I righteousness and strength, even to him shall men come, and all that are incensed against him shall be ashamed. Isaiah 45 verse 23 and 24. Amid the ransom throng are the apostles of Christ, the heroic Paul, the ardent Peter, the love and loving John, and their true-hearted brethren, and with them the vast host of martyrs, while outside the wall, with every vile and abominable thing, are those by whom they were persecuted, imprisoned, and slain. There is Nero, that monster of cruelty and vice, beholding the joy and exaltation of those whom he once tortured, and in whose extremest anguish he found satanic light. His mother is there to witness the result of her own work, to see how the evil stamp of character transmitted to her son, the passions and courage and developed by her influence and example, have borne fruit in crimes that caused the world to shudder. There is the proud, ambitious Napoleon, whose approach had caused kingdoms to tremble. There are papious priests and prelates who claim to be Christ's ambassadors, yet employed the trap, the dungeon, and the stake to control the conscience of his people. There are the proud pontiffs who exalted themselves above God and presumed to change the law of the Most High. Those pretended fathers of the church have an account to render to God from which they would fain be excused. Too late, they are made to see that the omniscient one is jealous of his law and that he will in no wise clear the guilty. They learn now that Christ identifies his interest with that of his suffering people, and they feel the force of his own words. Inasmuch as ye have done it unto one of the least of these my brethren, ye have done it unto me. Matthew 25, verse 40. The whole wicked world stand arraigned at the bar of God on the charge of high treason against the government of heaven. They have none to plead their cause. They are without excuses, and the sentence of eternal death is pronounced against them.
High, yes, so high, from the depths of the sea, creations revealing the majesty. From the corners of all,
my heart is so proud. My heart is so unfocused. I see the things you do to me as great things I have done. And now you gently break me, lovingly you take me. And mold me as my maker. I ask you, how many times will you pick me up when I keep on letting you down? And each time I will fall short of your glory, how far will forgiveness abound? And you answer my troubles, I love you, and as long as you're seeking my face, you walk in the path of my daily sufficient grace. At times I may grow weak and feel a bit discouraged, knowing that someone, somewhere, can do a better job. For who am I to serve you? I know I don't deserve you. The kingdom of the Lord, the burns in my heart that keeps me hanging on. I ask you, how many times will you pick me up when I keep on letting you down? And each time I will fall short of your glory, how far will forgiveness abound? And you answer my child, I love you, and as long as you're seeking my face, you walk in the heart of my daily sufficient grace. You are so patient with me, Lord. As I walk with you, I'm learning about what your grace really means. God's a part of God that paid as Calvary. Instead of trying to repay you, I'm learning to simply obey you. I'm giving up my life to you for all that you've given to me. I ask you why.
will forgive